Dear colleagues, my name is Anastasia Irina. I am a research assistant of the Laboratory of Molecular Mechanisms of Aging at the St. Petersburg Institute of Bioregulation and Gerontology. I am a PhD student of the Department of General Pathology and Pathological Physiology at the St. Petersburg Institute of Experimental Medicine. Today, I'd like to focus on neuroprotective effects of shorter diets in vivo model of Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer's disease is the most common neurodegenerative disorder that causes progressive memory loss in older people. Furthermore, Alzheimer's disease is a global medical, social, and economic problem. This is due to the fact that cognitive, behavioral, and psychological symptoms cause progressive disability of patients and reduced quality of life in AD. Alzheimer's disease is one of the most common reasons of death, within from 5 to 12 years of first detected symptoms. It should be pointed out that currently approved drugs for the treatment of Alzheimer's disease don't prevent or slow down the neurodegenerative processes. These drugs have considerable side effects that turn incompatible to normal vital activities of patients. By this reason, development of safe and effective therapeutic agents for a treatment of Alzheimer's disease is becoming increasingly relevant purpose of modern medicine. EGR and KID peptides are promising compounds for treatment of Alzheimer's disease in view of low immunogenicity, lack of side effects, and high physiological activity. Today, we are talking about neuroprotective effects of short peptides, EGR and KID, in vivo model of Alzheimer's disease. It should be noted that EGR and KID peptides are active components of dietary supplements Tableten and Benford respectively. 5FA transgenic line of mice is a main model of Alzheimer's disease that is characterized by 5 mutations associated with familial form of AD. Speaking on neuroprotective effects of short peptides, it should be emphasized on synaptic dysfunction underlying the cognitive impairments in Alzheimer's disease. It should be noted that neuronal connection is provided by synaptic contacts that is formed by means of presynaptic terminal from one neuron and postsynaptic terminal from second neuron. Impaired neurotransmission reflects changing in functional state of synapses and decreased protein synthesis involved in neurotransmission. These changes trigger the changing in postsynaptic morphology, that is the cellular basis of learning and memory impairments. It should be noted that 5FA transgenic line of mice doesn't allow to visualize neurons in the brain. By this reason, a 5FA-M line of mice was developed by means of crossbreeding of 5FA and M line of mice. It should be noted that 5FA transgenic line of mice doesn't allow to visualize neurons in the brain. By this reason, a 5FA line of mice was developed by crossbreeding of 5FA line of mice and M line of mice that is characterized by synthesis of green fluorescent protein. The successful development of the transgenic 5FA M line of mice made it possible to avoid time-consuming immunohistochemical staining of brain slices, thereby greatly facilitated the visualization of neuronal structures in vivo and evaluation of the dendritic spine morphology in a mouse brain. It was shown that 5-fat M-line of mice is characterized by progressive elimination of the most functionally active mushroom spines in the CE1 area of hippocampus. This is a part of the brain involved in memory formation. These findings provide a conclusion that a new transgenic line of mice can be useful tool for evaluation of the effect of short peptides in a dendritic spine morphology in Alzheimer's disease. Moving on, I'd like to point out the design of the investigation. The experimental groups were following. The first one, the M-line of mice injected by physiological solution. The second one was the 5-fat M-line of mice injected physiological solution too. Third one was a 5-fat line of mice injected by EDR peptide, that's phenylalanine. And the last one was a 5-fat M line of mice injected by KIT peptide, that's lesogen. Fixed brain slices were taken after cross injection of peptides. Prepared fixed slices were directly analyzed by means of confocal microscopy, followed by obtaining the microphotographs of neuronal dendrites in the mouse hippocampus. On the next step, morphological analysis of dendritic spines was carried out by specific software. That's studying the shape of spines in order to separate into main types, including stubby, thin, and mushroom. Shape of spines reflect the functional state of synaptic contacts and neurotransmission as a whole. Thus, evaluation of morphological characteristics of spines in 5-fat M-line of mice injected by EDR and KIT peptides allowed to analyze the effect of these compounds on functional state of neuronal networks in AD. Let's look at the result of the present investigation. We can see a lot of spines, including mushroom spines, side by white arrow in the control case. This fact is reflected on the graph as a high level of dendritic spine density and mushroom spines number side by white columns. We can see loss of spines on neuronal dendrites in 5-fat M transgenic line of mice. It's presented on the graph as a reduced level of dendritic spine density and mushroom spines number, signed by black columns. This decline is explained by negative impact of neurodegeneration on stability of the synaptic contacts and neuronal networks as a whole. It should be noted a lot of spines of neurons in a 5-fat M line of mice injected by EDR peptide. The graphs show the statistically significant rising level of spine density and mushroom spines number signed by green columns. We can also see pleural spines on neuronal dendrites in 5-fat M line of mice injected by KIT peptides, that's lesogen. This fact is reflected on the graph as a high level of dendritic spine density and mushroom spines number signed by red columns. Thus, we have demonstrated the neuroprotective effects of phenylalanine and lesogen on dendritic spine density and mushroom spines number in vivo model of Alzheimer's disease. We can suggest, according to these findings, that these peptides improve functional state of neuronal networks in the mouse model of Alzheimer's disease. It's an important result for future investigation into neuroprotective effects of these compounds on cognition in neurodegenerative conditions. In conclusion, it should be noted that EDR and KIT peptides as active compounds may be recommended to future investigation. in order to develop a safe and effective therapeutic agent for the treatment of Alzheimer's disease. Pinealon and Rezogen, as well as the complex dietary supplements based on cattle vessels and brain, are appropriate to be used in order to prevent age-associated neurodegenerative disorders, including AD. That's all I have to discuss in the present lecture. Thank you for your attention.